Hi, everyone, and thank you for joining this FAST summit. We also wanted to thank FAST for putting this together and allowing us to present an update on our stem cell gene therapy approach for Angelman syndrome. My name's Joe Anderson. I'm an associate professor at UC Davis, and I'll be the one giving you this update today. So our therapeutic approach involves an insertional gene therapy where we want to insert a functional and modified form of UBE3A into blood stem cells, also known as hematopoietic stem cells. So once this gene is inserted, those blood stem cells and the immune system cells which are derived from them will be able to express and deliver UBE3A to affected cells. We chose a lentiviral vector system to insert the gene into the blood stem cells due to the fact that the gene will then be permanently inserted and integrated into the cells for the life of the cell and for also all daughter cells that arise from that blood stem cell. We chose the blood system as a delivery system due to the fact that it can reach almost any part of the body, including the brain, where the cells can be derived into microglia to express UBE3A and then deliver it to the affected neurons. So the way that this would work is we would have our blood stem cells, we would gene modify them using a lentiviral vector that expresses UBE3A, and then these blood stem cells can then be derived into immune system cells, as I mentioned, the microglia in the brain, which would then express UBE3A and deliver it to the affected neurons. So where we are at in this current therapeutic timeline. So in collaboration with Jill Silverman's lab and Dave Siegel's lab, we've completed all of the proof of concept and preclinical studies. We've assembled a pre-IND package, submitted it to the FDA. We've received responses back from the FDA, and we're currently working on the IND enabling studies. I don't want to give a timeline on how long these IND enabling studies will take, but I'm guessing within the next year, we should be able to submit the IND for the FDA for a clinical trial, phase one clinical trial in Angelman syndrome patients. So the way that this clinical trial would work, it would be an autologous transplant. So autologous meaning using a patient's own stem cells. This would stop any rejection from occurring as from using a donor stem cell that is not the patient's own. And so we are able to get enough of these stem cells from a patient to then gene modify, infuse back into the patient, and create an immune system that would then deliver this UBE3A gene throughout the body. So the way that this clinical trial will initially work is that we will be recruiting and enrolling adult patients as the FDA considers this more than minimal risk for pediatric patients. And we would take mobilized peripheral blood stem cells from the adult patients and gene modify them with the UBE3A expressing lentiviral vector. We will do that outside of the body in our GMP facility. And then once the patient is ready to receive these stem cells, we will then infuse those cells back into the patients. And then we will monitor the patients for safety and efficacy of the therapy. And then once we're able to show the safety profile in adult patients, we will then potentially be able to start enrolling pediatric patients. So I'd like to acknowledge everyone that's been involved with this project. My lab members, Julie Haley and our vivarium staff, including Janine, Dr. Siegel's lab, everyone in Dr. Silverman's lab, and then our clinical team, the PI of the clinical trial, who will be Dr. Abetti, and then Dr. Nalta, Geraldine, and Bill, and then also the funding for this research, Foundation for Angelman Syndrome, UC Davis Stem Cell Program, and the MIND Institute. Want to thank everyone again for watching this FAST Summit and also to FAST for putting this on. Thank you very much.